This is The Rundown. I'm Hari Srinivasan. I'm not the usual suspect for interviews on poetry books, but this one really caught my attention. It's called Atomic Romances, Molecular Dances. It's a book of chemistry poetry. Some of the titles include Bridge Over Troubled H2O, Combusta Rhymes, Sex and Acidity, Charged with Salt and Battery. The author is Mala Radhakrishnan. She is a biophysical chemist and an assistant professor at Wellesley College. She's using poetry to help students understand chemical concepts and things like thermodynamics and quantum mechanics and a lot more. Now, she joins us from a chemistry lab today in this building, and it's only for the sake of the interview. She wants to point out that under any other circumstances, she would have her safety goggles on. So, thanks for being with us.
Thank you.
Okay, so let's start with, what is this book about, and why are you starting to write chemistry poetry? It's fascinating, but why did you do this?
I always found it difficult when I heard people say, oh, you know, chemistry was so difficult, it was the worst subject I had in high school. And whereas when I always think of chemistry, I think of what are the atoms feeling on a molecular level and an atomic level. And in a lot of ways, the kinds of reactions that they experience are similar to the kinds of relationships that people experience. And I feel like humanizing chemistry and teaching chemical concepts through stories and narratives has helped people understand it in the past. And I've taught high school chemistry and college chemistry, and I find that teaching through analogies and stories has really been an effective way.
So you also taught at high school at some point. Were you just seeing that what kids were listening to and memorizing hip-hop faster than they were memorizing the periodic table?
Well, I mean, I think, you know, students have certain things on their minds, and, you know, they're thinking about relationships and they're thinking about parties. And if you use the things that, you know, are on their minds and really tell them that at the molecular level, chemistry is just a soap opera going on, it helps them relate to it, and it helps them think about those concepts. And then if you work the math in, it's almost like they don't realize the math is being worked in. It's like you're sneaking it in.
And what about the idea of poetry itself? I heard you went to different poetry slams just to watch and then started to perform these?
Yeah, I mean, the whole thing started because a friend of mine invited me to go to an open mic and a poetry slam. I went for a few weeks every week, and I was just fascinated by the kinds of different subjects people could turn into a poem. So I finally started writing some poems, and they weren't initially about chemistry, but then I thought, hey, you know, hey, I am a chemist, and why don't I write about something that I know really well? And so the first poem I ever wrote about chemistry was called As the Magnetic Stir Bar Turns, and I read it at the open mic, and they really liked it, and most of the audience, obviously, there were few chemists in the audience, but they could really relate to the concepts there. And that's when I thought that chemistry poetry could actually be an educational tool to get people excited about chemistry when they wouldn't maybe otherwise be.
So you've got this self-published book, but what's next? Are there lesson plans that go with this if a chemistry teacher or professor somewhere else wants to make their students read it?
Well, I mean, I think the topics that I've chosen really fit well into intro chemistry course or more advanced chemistry courses. So I have topics, poems about thermodynamics and kinetics, about common types of reactions, equilibria. So the kinds of topics that people teach in standard chemistry courses. And so if they're teaching a particular topic on a day, they might say, here's a poem about acids and bases. I'm going to read this. And it really follows up nicely with the lesson that they're trying to teach.
So how have your fellow faculty, or even family for that matter, received this? I mean, are they now pretty used to your scientific puns left and right?
Yeah, I think it's part of my innate personality also to throw in chemistry puns in everyday sort of nerdy scientific language when I speak, and I encourage my students to do that too. So, for example, I teach physical chemistry, and so I'm always constantly telling my students to use the words orthogonal and eigenstate in their everyday conversations. So that comes across. They're pretty used to me by now, both in terms of my poetry and my everyday language. So,
there are lots of different narratives that you have running through your poetry. Sometimes it's about love, sometimes it's about loss. What is it in everyday life and kind of romance that you can find a chemical parallel to?
Yeah, so a really good example to that would be we teach in kinetics that a catalyst can speed up how fast a reaction happens, but it can't make a reaction happen that wouldn't otherwise happen. So the analogy there is, you know, a matchmaker can bring two people together, but if those two people aren't compatible, you know, the matchmaker just helps them find out faster that they're not compatible. It can't make a reaction happen that wouldn't happen. So the poem that tries to convey this concept is called L'Amour the Barrier, and it's about a molecule who really wants to get together with another molecule and tries to find a catalyst to help this happen. And of course, the catalyst does get them together faster, but then they find out they're incompatible and that it wouldn't happen. And so it doesn't have necessarily a happy ending in this case. Other poems do have happy endings, but it does get that idea across that a catalyst can speed up a reaction, but it won't make a reaction happen that wouldn't otherwise happen.
Okay, well, we'll have you read a poem in a separate video, but thank you so much for your time.
Thank you, Hari.
All right. Again, the book is called Atomic Romances, Molecular Dances. The author is Mala Radhakrishnan, faculty member at the chemistry department at Wellesley College. This is The Rundown. I'm Hari Srinivasan. Stay with us.